to where I am.
Boom, shack, shack, shack the room.
Okay, boom, shake the room. There's Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. And we have a fax here from Andy of Carolides. It's a family sandwich bar, Wood Green, North London. It says here, fax us your sandwich and pizza orders. Well, Andy, what about the cheese gumming up the machine, old friend? Anyway, it says, I'd like to send a message to Julie. It says, I know she's listening. She listens to the radio every morning. I'd like to say I like her a lot. And I'm really, really sorry about last night. The time coming up to 10:47 a.m.
Those tour dates have been put back to June, unfortunately, so you can get refunds at any vending office. Okay, now it's coming up to 6 o'clock, and we're going to go to Hazel Murray at the news.
Where are you going? Not even 6?
Out. Going out? I thought we were going to that benefit for the homeless. One of them's reading a poem, and there's vegetable kebabs.
Not tonight. I've got a date.
Oh, a date! Julie's got a date. So, what's his, or her name?
Andy. His name's Andy.
And, what does he do?
He, works in the family sandwich bar.
Hmm.
I think that's probably only temporary because he's just got out of the army. He's nice. He's going a bit bald. I think that bothers him. He brushes his hair back.
Why?
I know. We tell them over and over, baldness doesn't bother us. For once, we're not lying. Not like we are about the knob-sized thing.
Oh, yeah?
Anyway, running late. Mustache. Night.
Well, that's rich. The poor can go hang while you live it up with General Schwarzkopf.
Sod it. Nothing. War drought.
The rail dispute escalates as the union announces 5 days of disruption to the railways. ACAS says it can find no basis for bringing the two sides back to the negotiating table.
Hooray!
The Bank of England says interest rates will have to rise in the next few months to keep inflation down.
Hooray!
As British troops arrive in Rwanda, new fears that fighting will flare up again.
Hooray!
Dad, I bought one of your handmade shirts, please, can I, Dad? And your silk tie, and your gold cufflinks, Dad.
Bloody pathetic. Grown man borrowing his clothes. We're not bloody sisters, you know.
You are an institutionalised psychopath. You wouldn't know what clothes to buy unless an officer told you.
Okay, ladies, beige is screamingly fashionable for the autumn. But with your eye colour, never ever go near Cerise.
Well, what do you expect me to do? Go on my first date dressed in my old biological warfare suit?
Hey, you finally managed to get a date? With a girl?
No. With another craft. Why shouldn't I get a date? I'm a war hero. I was decorated during the Falklands.
When you say you were decorated, you mean you was always plastered.
Anyway, where'd you meet her? You never bloody go anywhere.
Well, I met her at these Labour Party meetings you haven't noticed me going to every Tuesday. She's a solicitor. She's always getting people off who've got numbers after their names. You know, like the Renault 5 and the Leicester 6 and the Snow White 7. Honest, Dad, she's brilliant.
I bet she farts like everybody else.
How do all these Labour Party lefties feel about having a trained killer in their midst?
Michael, these people are socialists. They are rational, educated, sensitive human beings.
You scared them shitless, right?
They act like they're in the room with a deranged hippo. All except Julie, that is. Julie Cordova, she's called.
Ooh, Julie.
Hey, that's my bell.
report has...
And my suit? Where did you find that? I didn't it?
Time spent on reconnaissance, seldom wasted. I'm off out now. Don't wait up.
There's been some interest in cash payments for returning to work. On next week's long weekend of strikes...
Yeah, of course they're fresh. That's 100% animal, that is, mate. Yeah, it's gone, isn't it? It's all gone for this Chinese boat. In an escort. Ah, to give up, mate. Yeah, of course they are.
I'm late.
That'd be 2 quid.
I'm sorry, there was a problem with the cab.
Oh, it's all right, I've only just got here myself.
Oh, there you are! He was getting right wound up. We thought you stood him up, didn't we, mate?
Have a nice evening, then. Yeah. Yeah, it's a Chinese bloke looking for you, love.
You've heard of the powers that be. Well, I represent the powers that don't be. My husband, well, my ex-husband, I had a physical breakdown. It's not surprising my workload then. He proved to be the usual tower of weakness, left me while I was in treatment. Great sense of timing, like most men. Ooh. anyway, now, when I'm not at work, I'm doing stuff for the Labour Party.
Oh, yeah, the Labour Party.
What do you mean? Oh, yeah, the Labour Party.
I've been to quite a few meetings now, you know. And well, I don't know about any other branches, but don't you think people in our branch, well, they're a bit mental?
You know, I reckon that's the meetings, because that's all politics is really, is meetings. The Russian Revolution was just a meeting that got out of hand. But normal, ordinary people have got much better things to do than go to meetings all the time.
Well, so, what? The country ends up being run by antisocial misfits who've got too much time on their hands.
Yeah, people like us, in fact.
Look, I'm sorry for what I said before about us being misfits. You know, there are certain tribes in New Guinea who consider mad women who say the first thing that comes into their mind is extremely attractive.
When are you going there then?
The big issue. Buy the magazine that helps the homeless.
I've got one, mate.
I'll have one. Keep the change.
Cheers, thanks a lot. Have a nice night now.
Thank you. Alright, so let's work this out. Big issue comes out on a Monday, right? Today's Thursday. So you've got what? 4 copies?
6. I bought 3 on Wednesday from a woman with a particularly scabby dog. I told her I was going to give them as wedding presents.
I can't wait for Christmas.
Did you know something like 25% of the homeless have been in the services? Ex-service people have terrible trouble forming relationships. They are often the most hopeless social inadequates.
You know, actually, I reckon a spell in the army would do most people a lot of good.
What? Discipline, short haircuts, learning to ski, all that crap.
Nah, that's a load of bollocks. But you know, in the 1945 general election, the returning servicemen gave the Labour Party the biggest landslide they've ever had. You know why? Because they spent the last 5 years right up close to officers. You'd seen for the first time what dribbling cretins the ruling class really are. And then, you forgot, and things returned to so-called normal. It's like if people could see all those morons that went to Oxford and Cambridge.
I went to Cambridge, actually.
Yeah, but somebody who had all your advantages and has still managed to make such a cock-up of their life can't be all bad.
what do we do now?
Well, I live at home with my dad and my brother.
I'm lodging with his family, solicitor friends, you know.
So?
So. I've got it. Let's have another drink. In fact, let's stay out all night drinking. We'll show the world we're not really Labour Party geeks. We're mad us. We're crazy. We're wild and free, and we don't wear a vest.
Yeah, but it's really difficult to get a drink when the pubs are closed.
Look, if we can't manage to get a drink outside licensing hours, then we are pretty sorry individuals. Let's start out drinking now and carry on until the pubs reopen at 11.
Yeah, but you've got to be at work in the morning. I've got to be at my dad's sandwich bar by 8.
That's right. We'll turn up looking all dishevelled and shagged out. People will wonder what we've been up to.
We'll show them. We're white. We're middle-aged. We live at home. And we can still have a good time.
If we want to get pissed, we better get to the pubs.
Jesus, they're nearly closed. Come on.
So what are we going to do? Well, I've heard that in certain pubs they have what they call a stay-behind. You know, they lock the doors and people carry on drinking.
Yeah, it's worth a try.
Excuse me, mate. I'm a squaddy, just got out of the army, you know. Only been in town an hour. And, well, I was wondering whether there was anywhere soldier could get a drink like, you know.
Well, it's after closing time.
Yeah, I know that. I was just wondering whether you had, stay behind.
A what?
A lock-in. A late taste, a snifter under the table.
Oh, around here we call that obtaining an alcoholic beverage after the expiry of licensing hours.
Yeah, that'll be it, yeah.
Well, I shouldn't tell you this, but you can have an after-hours drink here. But it's for a select few, and you have to know the code, like.
Code?
Yes. Well, you see, what you do is you leave the pub with everybody else, wait a few minutes, then go round the back, knock 3 times, and then sing 2 verses of Men of Harlech, as seen in the film Zulu. Do you know it?
Yeah, it stars Michael Caine and Stanley Baker, and interestingly enough, Chief Mangosuthu Buthelezi as Chaka King of the Zulus.
No, no, the song.
Oh, yeah, sort of.
All right. You know the drill. We'll have a drink together. In a few minutes.
Do you know why we have these stupid licensing laws in England?
No.
So we won't lose the First World War. Yeah, you see, during the First World War, the artillery shells weren't exploding. The bureaucrats blamed the munition workers in Carlisle, said they were drunk all the time, so they brought in licensing laws.
It's ridiculous.
I know, but if you don't want to see the Kaiser's armies marching down Whitehall, you better be happy to do your drinking by 11. Unless you know the code, that is.
Men of Harlech, mobile phones ringing, joining in the karaoke singing. Can you feel your trousers pinging at the Chinese buffet? Men of Harlech, sandwiches killing, can you feel your book end?
Never get in. You've got to look groovy or they won't let you in.
Yeah, but if we do get in, we'll get a drink.
We'll go deaf as well. Is there a gland that triggers in your body when you're in your late 30s that makes you go off pop music? I listen to the radio every morning and I try to get into the music, but I can't.
I know, when you go off pop music, you've got nothing left to replace it with. You know, I think there's nothing sadder, right, than middle-aged people who are still listening to the music that they were into when they were kids, you know?
Yeah. My ex-husband made me go to this Eric Clapton concert a couple of years ago. It was sad. All these balding accountants and doctors playing air guitar. It doesn't give you much confidence when you see a senior eye surgeon in his pinstripe suit going, Layla, Eric is God, mate.
Oh, hang on.
See, I told you, ageist bastard, this has got to be against the law.
You can go in now. What? You can go in now. You just have to be careful not letting too many people in. Fire regulations, you know. Peace. Okay.
Yeah. Peace. Amazonian tree bark, and we've got Ribena. Or there's a man over there who'll sell you a pot. Ecstasy that'll make your teeth feel like ping pong balls. Or acid that'll paralyze you down one side and make you think you're the president of Nigeria. But definitely no alcohol. Alcohol's bad for you, man.
We've got to get a drink.
It's all right, we'll get a drink soon. At the next place, we will definitely get a drink. We are definitely going to be pissed before the pubs reopen. Do they sell booze in those places?
Nah, they just flog your coloured water at £100 a bottle.
And how do you know?
I read about it in The Guardian.
Well, there's got to be somewhere we can get a drink.
Stand still, that man there! Sergeant! Corporal! By the light, that's the one to say!
Yeah! Hey! Andy, how are you?
Great! This is Julie.
Hi.
Greg, C Company Motors.
This is Mark.
Hi.
So, where are you off to then?
We've just gone to a club.
Do they sell drink there?
Yeah.
Great. Could we tag along? We were just looking for somewhere to have a drink.
Well, there might be a bit of a problem. It's a gay club.
Oh. But they do sell drink?
Yeah, but they're not very keen on straight people.
Yeah, but they do sell drink.
Yeah, I said that, but...
Oh, come on, Greg, we can get them in. Don't be so miserable.
Ooh. All right, then. Is that in Wood Green? We were just going to get the night bus.
All right, then. Well, fun patrol. Well, mate.
I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet, I've got no rhythm. No, I'm never gonna dance again. The way I dance with you.
Look, look, there's our cafe.
It's
just think we could be sitting up there watching telly like boring people, instead of being out here on this adventure.
Yeah, what's the thing?
It's 1 a.m. and here are the headlines. Interest rates set to rise again.
Hooray!
A giant poison cloud hovers over Uzbekistan.
Hooray!
And new evidence of widespread drug abuse in sport.
Hooray!
All those stories after the break.
Would you like another beer, Michael?
Don't mind if I do.
How about some cheese and toast?
That'd be nice, yeah.
Can I have some lettuce with it? Why not? This is the life, eh? Yeah.
This is the life.
La, 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 la. Okay. Right. Who wants to sing us a song now? Come on, somebody. Give us a song. If anybody sings us a song, I'll give them a nice Caribbean. Oh, come on! Who'll sing us a song for a beer?
Me, me.
I'll sing a song for some beer.
Right, on you go then, pal.
If I were not upon the stage, someone else I'd like to be. If I were not upon the stage, a bus conductor I'd like to be. You'd hear me all day long singing out this song. Any more fares, please, any more fares, please. No more room on top, ching, ching. Any more fares, please, any more fares, please. No more room on top, ching, ching. If I was not upon the stage, someone else I'd like to be. If I was not upon the stage, a sailor I'd like to be. You'd hear me all day long singing out this song. Splice the main brace, splice the main brace. Yes, me hearties, yes, me hearties. Splice the main brace, splice the main brace. Yes, me hearties. Ah.
Jesus, pal. You must want to drink bad to do that, eh?
Look, I sang the bloody song. Now give me the frigging beer.
Aye, 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 okay, okay. No problem. Here you go, pal. My beer!
All right, all you bloody drunks, off this bus. You're ruining everybody's journey. Now, come on.
Well, it's not that far away. Guess we can walk from here.
Yeah, it's a nice night. We can walk from here.
You've got very cheery all of a sudden, haven't you?
When you're a defense lawyer, you train yourself to ignore all the evidence staring you straight in the face. So I feel I can confidently say, without fear of contradiction, we are having a good time and everything's going to be great.
Right, that's the spirit. Well, let's go.
I've had a word with Tony, and I've told him that Andy's a gay guy from out of town, so he won't be coming here very often. He just wants to have a quick word, and I'll give you a temporary membership, and then I'll allow you a guest for the evening.
Right, yeah, I can pretend to be a gay guy, yeah.
What do you mean, pretend to be a gay guy? Gay people are just the same as everybody else. Just act natural, and don't do some terrible faggy performance.
Okay. Craig, I'm not Sam Neanderthal, all right?
Yeah, sorry.
I'm Greg's special friend. I think he told you about me. I want to be a member. Oh, God, I love what you've done with these walls. Oh, they're absolutely fantastic. Oh, Christ, I love your jacket. Where did you get it? Oh, it's absolutely fantastic. Oh, God. Oh, I love your belts as well. Where did you get that? Do you like Lisa Minnelli? Oh, I love it. I want to stay at the Albert Hall. Lovely flux on boy dancing.
Honestly, all you had to do was just be normal. You turned into Mae West.
I know. I'm sorry. Something just clicked in my head and I became Puff the Magic Drag Queen. We've got to get a drink.
I'm fed up. I want to go home now. I've had enough of being wild and free and having a good time. I don't want to drink anymore.
No! You've got to get a drink!
I don't want to drink.
The drink's not important.
So we can go home.
No, it's because the drink's not important that it's so important that we get a drink.
It's a bit bloody late for riddles. What are you talking about?
Look, do you see? It's a symbol of us. We can't even manage to get a drink. We can't even manage to have an adventure. If we go home now, all we'll remember about this night is that we got thrown out of a club and we didn't get a drink. We'll associate each other with failure. Yeah, we'll see each other a few times, but it won't work. We'll drift apart. We'll move into solitary bedsits and grow old laughing madly at the gas meter for entertainment. And then we'll die unfulfilled.
Andy! We just didn't manage to get a drink, that's all. All that other stuff, it's crazy. There is no symbolism in this. There is no symbolism.
Is that right? Is that right? If that's the case, then why is the figure of death standing in the middle of the road?
We don't know the people whose party it is.
Don't worry. I'll black our way in. I'm really good at this.
Hi. I'm a friend of Mike's.
Oh, well, you better come in then.
Hello. Evening.
Yes, we did it. We finally got a drink.
I don't think so, Andy. Look at the can.
Birtwanger, old Bavarian,
non-alcoholic style Pilsner. What the hell? Non-alcoholic style bloody what?
Ponto Vecchio and Vino Senza Alcohol, produce of Ulster, non-alcoholic special brew, non-alcoholic spirit. What's the point of that? For people who want to pretend to be alkies, we have got to get a drink. There's got to be some real lager here for the infidels.
We heard you say you're a friend of Mike.
Is this true?
Well, you know, we're close, but we don't necessarily see a lot of each other.
Well, we think Mike stinks.
We think Mike has the reprehensible morals of a civet cat.
Well, I don't think that's right, actually. And we think it is right. And in appearance, the fabulous so-called Mike resembles the stinking carcass of a long-dead hippopotamus.
Hiya. Well, let me tell you a few things about Mike. You two aren't fit to clean behind Mike's cooker. Yeah, if you two both had a dick transplant, you'd still be a 17th of a man that Mike is. Let me tell you, right, do you know about the time that Mike rescued those orphans from a burning building? You don't know about it, do you?
No, we don't.
No? Well, how about the time Mike single-handedly landed a light aircraft because the pilots had a heart attack? Well, I can open them.
Andy, you don't know who Mike is.
What? You're turning on Mike as well?
You talk to fork!
You two just piss off, or me and Michael have something to say about it.
I am going. You have managed to find the only teetotal student in the Western world. Now face it, this
evening is a washout. I am going home.
Julie!
Come back here! Come on!
Where the hell are we?
Somewhere in the 1950s, I think.
Tottenham. I think we might be in Tottenham. You've got blood on your nose.
Made a cab.
Eh?
I said, do you want the minicab?
I don't think so, thank you. I always use licensed black taxis.
There you go, then.
Hang on a minute. You reckon you could take us somewhere where we could get a drink?
Sure. Me and my cab can take you anywhere.
I don't think it's a good idea. I said I wanted to go home. I didn't say I wanted to be in Nightmare on Elm Street.
Oh, no, this is it. This is it. Don't you understand? It's going to be all right. This is it. Come on. So how about it, then? Definitely take us somewhere where we can get a drink. This place.
Drink me, make you stinky, eh? Yeah, I definitely know a place. Bit of a trip, though. East up the river a ways.
But you're absolutely certain that they've got drink there?
Oh, they got drink, all right. Come on. P.O.B. Battle of Onderman, over.
Booker, Miles Davis says Jabba Quiddigan out.
Jeez, this isn't a minicab ride, it's a frigging attraction at Disneyland. Forget Space Mountain or the Cyclone, they should have one called Minicab Ride, the Ultimate Terror.
Yeah, I never used to be a minicab driver. Used to be a stuntman in the movies.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's right, Missy, even if you don't believe it. I was a stuntman with a difference. I didn't take any safety precautions. Just used to get horribly hurt all the time.
Great plan! But isn't the point that you do the stunt and try not to get hurt?
Well, your average stuntman, he takes all these safety precautions. But if you don't bother with any of that, you can work a lot faster, see? You see that Bond movie, The Living Daylights? Bloke falls out of a sixth-floor window. That was me. Well, they were putting mattresses down then. I said to the director, Richard Donner, I said, don't bother with it, mate. Don't bother. I fell 30 feet on the concrete. Didn't do me any harm. Did you see Indiana Jones in The Last Crusade? Black run over by a tank. It was me. Director Steve Spielberg, he told them to dig a safety trench. I said, look, Stevie, mate, we're talking across tortoises here. Don't bother with it, mate, just run me over. And he did. Didn't do me no harm.
There isn't a club here.
I never said I was taking you to a club.
In a few minutes, a party boat will come past here. It comes past every Thursday night. All you have to do is jump off the jetty onto the boat. Nobody will notice.
I'm not jumping. It's dangerous.
What? I did something 20 times harder than that on Marathon Man. I had to leap off a moving train onto a coal barge loaded with 22 tons of anthracite. Didn't do me any harm. All you need's a bit of nerve, see? Here she comes. Here she comes.
I just want to go home.
I just thought we'd have some fun.
Well, maybe people like us weren't meant to have fun.
Believe it. This isn't happening.
Oh dear.
Not to me.
She said she wanted a proper taxi. Now you've got a taxi. Now shut up.
Shit, the old bill. I don't want to get dragged in again this week. I want to get home in time for school.
Better drop his baby off then.
God. This is my house. This is where I live.
What?
This is where I live. With those solicitor friends I told you about. Here. I live here.
Right. Well,
thanks for the date. Super. Terrific. Fantastic.
We haven't had a drink yet.
A drink. We haven't even got home with our clothes intact. You and your quest for the holy ale.
I'm sorry, but...
Let's just review our date, shall we? You got rubbish thrown over you. Then we went to a disco, which has left me with a high-pitched noise in my ear. Then we were thrown off the night bus for being drunk, which we weren't, and which takes some doing. Then we got turfed out of a gay club for being too camp, for God's sake. You had a fight with some Arabs. Then we didn't jump on a boat. Then we were hijacked by some five-year-olds in a stolen taxi. And in none of these places did we get alcohol. We'd have had more luck getting a drink at Ayatollah Khomeini's house. I'm tired, Andy. I'm going to bed. Why don't you do the same?
Yeah. Bye then.
And we've got a fax here from Andy. Hi Andy, of Carolides or Carolides Family Sandwich Bar. Anyway, it's in Wood Green, North London. And on the fax here it says, fax us your sandwich and pizza orders. Andy, what about the cheese gumming up the machine, old friend? It also says, I'd like to send a message to Julie. It says, I know she listens to the radio every morning, and I'd like to say I like her a lot, and I'm really, really sorry about last night.
Cheers, Andy. We were really short of cleaning cloths until you did that to my suit. I still need something to polish my car with, though. Would you do me a favour? Borrow my new jeans tonight!
Are these premises licensed?
Unfortunately not for the sale of intoxicating liquor, no, but we can legally allow the consumption of an alcoholic beverage brought in by the customer if the aforementioned alcoholic beverage accompanies a light meal or a snack. And I might say that there is no corkage charge here.
Excellent. Two cheese rolls and two glasses, please. Will you join me? What time is it?
It's 10:59 a.m.
Pubs don't open for another 60 seconds.
Yes! We did it! We got a drink before the pubs opened.
We're not really dull people after all.
No. We're dead excited.
Imagine being old and wise.
So many things you can't do at my age. Like, go to comprehensive school.
Young and virile.
You know, when I drive down the street, everybody honks their horn.
Why do you think that is?
Because I drive on the right.
A real character.
I'm quite good looking, aren't I?
Imagine being all this and more on the Lenny Henry Christmas Show. Tomorrow, 8:30 on BBC One.
Dance to win on New Year's Eve with BBC One.
Come on, 100!
It's the story of a champion who had a dream.
What's wrong with me? What is so wrong with the way I dance?
A champion who risked everything.
I keep asking myself why.
Don't fail him as a mother.
A champion who followed his heart.
Fran, I just want to dance our steps.
Give a light in you, boy. Let it shine.
Drama on the dance floor in the network television premiere of Strictly Ballroom, New Year's Eve at 8:20 on BBC One.
Your Money or Your Life, now on BBC One. Comic chaos from a time gone by when rogues ruled the roads and the highway code hadn't been invented.